Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and I'm here to talk about Super Mario 3D World, which was revealed on this E3 through the Nintendo Direct thing. It looks like a cool game, and actually the graphics look fantastic. It looks like a fun Mario game, but as you can see from the title of this video, I don't care about it. I'm not excited about it. I'm kind of just like, whatever, a Mario game. And I think I feel this way because just recently, it's only been like 2 weeks, I got through Gamefly Super Mario 3D Land and I played it and I had fun with it, but it's just like I think I'm grown out of Mario. Throughout the experience I was like, I'm having fun, but this whole concept of gameplay for gameplay's sake, I've grown out of that idea. It's no longer just fun for me to just enjoy simply fun gameplay experiences. I don't know. I guess I'm the type of gamer that now actually likes games to have a story behind it, have something that really just immerses me into the universe of the game. And Super Mario 3D Land really didn't do that, because it's just like, I pick a level, I play this level, I beat the level, I try to find all the hidden golden stars, 3 golden stars, I come out, I enjoy it, and then I pick another level, and it's just like level to level to level to level, and then at the end of this, at the end of the string of levels, I do a boss level, and then I beat the boss level, and then I do another string of levels, I beat the boss level, which is much more challenging than the previous boss level, I do a string of levels. It's kind of trite, and the only reward you get from that experience is you get like some screenshots that kind of keeps you, the motivation to keep playing, the only motivation for Mario games to keep playing in this Mario game was to, because it's fun. Because the gameplay is fun, which is great. I think it's great that Nintendo focuses so much on gameplay. But that can't be it. Not to me. I think for kids, I think that's a great concept. You know, if I was younger and if I didn't play all these games so much, I think that it's still an enticing idea to like a game simply for gameplay. But I don't know. That's just not me anymore. I like to be surprised. I like to be surprised with new kind of universes. I like to be immersed in the game universe, and I also like to be engaged and motivated by the storytelling of the game's universe. It doesn't necessarily have to be a plot-driven thing. Flower, for example, you know, there's no dialogue in Flower. You just pretty much control a little pedal with the 6-axis motion control. That's pretty much all you do. But throughout that experience, every level, every experience is so new, and it's something that begs to be replayed, because you can reinterpret the level however you want to. It's something that I've never seen before, never experienced before. That's why I've been engaged in that. Super Mario 3D Land was all about trying to manipulate my nostalgia. You know, hey, remember how, you know, 2D Mario games used to be? Well, this level kind of looks like that. This has a concept of a flag. It's kind of like that, but hey, do you also remember that you really like playing Super Mario 64 and you really like Super Mario Galaxy? Well, here's a little tidbit of that, because this is in a 3D background and we're using this 3D feature of the 3DS. Isn't it fun? Yeah, it's fun. But I'm not driven to keep playing it. Like, I'm not totally engaged in it. And I've had fun with it. There were some concept that I think was pretty cool, pretty challenging. Like, when you jump, these platforms change whenever you jump. There are rotating platforms. There's all these kind of interesting concepts that are there, but it's just, I had fun. And then I see the Super Mario 3D World, which is like kind of the similar thing with extremely prettier graphics and with the cat suit. So, and the cat suit seems like another windsuit, because Tanuki suit really, really helped things with the Super Mario 3D Land. But Super Mario 3D World, there's the cat suit. It looks pretty similar. It still seems like level to level to level, boss level, string of level to level to level. And granted, each level has its own unique platforming sections and its own unique ideas. There's a lot of creativity behind Mario games. I concede that fact. But at the same time, it just feels like another Mario game. And I know that that kind of feeling is wrong to have. Because it is not just another Mario game, because it has a lot of unique concepts It's going to be a ton of fun. But I think, honestly, the type of gamer I've become, I've kind of grown out of Mario's. It's weird. Although, I guess if Nintendo announced like Super Mario Galaxy 3, I think I would have been much more excited, just because I like a Mario game where I can just explore this overworld. I haven't played Super Mario Galaxy 2, but Super Mario Galaxy 1, you know, or Super Mario Sunshine, or Super Mario 64, you have this 3D universe you can just kind of explore around in before getting into a specific level. I like that. I like that a lot. And I think that's something that's been missing in Mario games since Super Mario Galaxy. You know, we have the new Super Mario Brothers, new Super Mario Brothers Wii, new Super Mario Brothers 2, new Super Mario Brothers Wii U, new Super Luigi, and then we have Super Mario 3D Land and Super Mario 3D World. All these games, you can't really explore their world. You can't be immersed in the world. You're just going from level to level to level, which I'm not too upset about, because there's some franchises where that works for me. I'm excited about Sonic Lost World, for example, and that's just going to be from level to level to level. But that franchise, for some reason, works so much more to me than Super Mario 3D Land or Super Mario 3D World. So if I didn't play Super Mario 3D Land, I think I would be much more excited about Super Mario 3D World. But I kind of feel like I've played this before. So my excitement level for this is just like, whatever, I don't really care for it. It's something that I expected Nintendo to do. It's their safe bet. I feel like they're going to do pretty good sales with it. It's going to get pretty good reviews. It's going to be a fun game. But I'm not surprised. I'm not wowed. It's not the type of universe that I don't feel myself that I'm going to be really immersed and engaged into. So that's pretty much my whole sentiment on the thing. Not to diss on the game, because I think Super Mario games are always great fun. But nowadays, I feel like Mario games, and I play them, because I was recently playing New Super Mario Brothers, the original New Super Mario Brothers, the DS game, on my 3DS. I was going through it and I was just like, this is cool, but I feel like I'm kind of going through the motions with this Mario game. And I feel like Mario is at that stage where he's kind of just, that franchise is just going through the motions. It needs new life into it. Nintendo really needs to breathe new life into the Mario franchise. And I hope their next step, their next Mario game, pushes that boundary again and really shocks us again. But I don't know, maybe I've just grown out of Mario games. I don't know. What do you guys think? Are you guys super excited about Super Mario 3D World? Or are you as jaded as I am about it? So thanks for watching, and cheers.